This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to construct an amortization schedule. So imagine you've got a situation that's like this. You've taken out a loan for $15,000. It's at 4.5% compounded monthly, and you've got monthly payments for 3 years. And we have to make an amortization table for that situation. Okay, so two steps we have to do before we can start filling in the table. The first thing is we're going to use the present value formula, and we'll figure out what the monthly payment amount should be. So I've already done that, and given this situation, the monthly payment would be $446.20. The other thing we have to do is figure out what the interest rate for each payment period is. So what we're going to do is take the annual interest rate, which is 4.5%. We'll turn that into a decimal. That would be 0.045. And then we want to divide that by the number of compounding periods every year. And since we're making monthly payments, we would divide that by 12. So if we do that calculation, we get 0.00375. That's the monthly interest rate. So I'm going to put that in here. Now, in reality, in a normal table, we wouldn't fill in these two amounts. I wouldn't put the $446.20 up here at the top where it says payment, and I wouldn't fill in the interest rate, but I want to be able to refer to that. So I'm just going to leave it in there for now. Okay, now we can start filling in the table. At 0 months, there are no payments. You've just taken out the loan. And so there's no interest on that, and there's no balance reduction, but we have to fill in the unpaid balance. The unpaid balance in this first line is the original amount of the loan. So we're going to start out with $15,000 as unpaid balance. Now, at the end of the first month, we have to make a payment. The payment is $446.20. It's always going to be that amount. I want to figure out how much of that payment was interest. So what I have to do is multiply the interest rate, this 0.00375, times the unpaid balance. When I do that multiplication, I get $56.25. So in other words, out of the payment, $56.25 was interest. The rest of it was paying off the principal. So what we're going to do is find the unpaid balance reduction. All that is what happens when you take the payment and subtract the interest. So we'll take the payment, $446.20, subtract the interest, which for this month was $56.25, and we get $389.95. This is the unpaid balance reduction, which means it's the amount we're reducing the unpaid balance by. So we'll take this amount and subtract it from the unpaid balance, which is $15,000. And what I'm going to get is $14,610.05. And now we're going to begin the process again for the second month. We'll fill in the payment. The payment is always going to be $446.20. And then we want to find out how much of that was interest. So once again, we'll take that monthly interest rate and multiply it by the new unpaid balance. In other words, we're multiplying the interest rate by whatever the bottom line is in the unpaid balance column, which is now $14,610.05. When I do that multiplication, I get $54.79. That's the amount of interest I paid. I want to find out how much of the principal I paid, which is what happens when I take the payment and subtract the interest. When I do that, what I get is $391.41. That's the amount I'm reducing the unpaid balance by. So I'm always going to be taking the bottom line in this unpaid balance reduction column and subtracting it from the bottom line in the unpaid balance column. Or in other words, subtracting $391.41 from $14,610.05. That means the new unpaid balance is $14,218.64. Okay, I'm going to do one more line of this. Once again, now we're at the end of the third month, the payment is $446.20. I want to find out how much of that was interest. So when I get to the interest column, what I'm always going to do is multiply the interest rate for that period. In other words, in this case, it's the monthly interest rate times the bottom line in the unpaid balance column. When I do that multiplication, I get $53.32. When I get to the unpaid balance reduction column, what I'm always going to do is take the payment and subtract the bottom line in the interest column. So when I do that, I get $392.88. And then when I'm ready for the unpaid balance column, what I do is I take the unpaid balance reduction, the bottom line in that column, and subtract it from the bottom line in the unpaid balance column to give me the new unpaid balance. So in this case, we're going to get $13,825.76. And then I would begin again. And before I finished, I would get rid of these notes that I made for myself. Okay, now, I've got a nicer version of this. This is the same numbers we did, plus a couple more months. I just want to make some comments about this. What you should notice is that your interest, the numbers in your interest column are getting smaller and smaller as you get further and further down on the schedule. You should also notice that the numbers in the unpaid balance reduction column are getting bigger and bigger. If you wanted to check things as you went along, you could add the number in the interest column and the number next to it in the unpaid balance reduction column, and you should always get the payment amount. When you look at the unpaid balance column, that number should also be getting smaller and smaller. Now, when you get to the very end of this process, you would expect that there would be a zero in the unpaid balance column. In other words, there should be no more balance left to pay. Probably, you're going to end up with either a few cents as a positive number or a few cents as a negative number. The reason for that is this. In a problem like this, where we've got 36 payments, and you're rounding numbers off each time you work through a payment, it's very likely that you're going to end up off by 1 or 2 cents either way. Okay, so if you're off by a couple of cents, don't worry about it. It doesn't mean you made a mistake. It just means there's what we call a rounding error. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.